Vedas. As Mahavishnu breathes, unlimited universes are generated from the pores of his skin. And as he breathes in, these universes are retracted. Thus, the universes continually go through endless cycles of manifest and unmanifest states. Mahavishnu then expands into each and every universe as Garbhadakshay Vishnu and lies on the serpent Ananta Shesh. When Garbhadakshay Vishnu opens his eyes and desires to create the subtle form of creation is generated from his abdomen, taking the form of a lotus stem and flower. From that lotus, a Brahma is born in each universe. The same Brahma now began to create the 14 planetary systems. Having created the planets, he created all immovable living entities, the various trees and plants. He created them with the lowest level of consciousness, yet able to feel a sensation of pain. Next, Brahma created the lower species of life, the numerous animals and birds. Though more conscious than plants, the animals would know only hunger and thirst, eating, sleeping, mating, and defending. Then he created humans. Finally, Brahma created the demigods, demons, and angels. Throughout history, many great thinkers have come to the conclusion that this universe has some higher intelligence behind it. But in more recent times, science claims to have solved the problems of creation. It is all due to a Big Bang. The origin of the Big Bang, they describe, is a point of zero volume, infinitesimal density, and immeasurable temperature. A mathematical impossibility known as a singularity. As Stephen Hawking, the great physicist since Einstein, remarks, the singularity is outside the scope of all presently known laws of physics. Nothing can be said about it, and all calculations on it go haywire. But even if the universe did begin with a singularity, where did it come from? Stumped by this problem, scientists try to solve it with the rebounding theory. The universe goes through an endless cycle of expansions and contractions. But even for this, there is no workable explanation. In fact, many prominent physicists have pointed out there still must have been a singularity at some point. Then there are virtual particles that almost exist, but not quite. Another well-accepted theory goes that once in a while, out of the sea of these virtual particles, one springs into real existence. But instead of just a particle, it happens to be an entire universe. Other ideas include a white hole, a cosmic quasar that gushes out universes, or a wormhole, a space-time tunnel, popular with Star Trek fans, no doubt. The list goes on. It is clear that the modern scientific theories on the origin of the universe are not based on verifiable facts. None of these theories can be proved or substantiated. The Vedas describe the origin of the universe as coming from a higher intelligence, giving precise details of how the universe expands and contracts, changing from a manifest to an unmanifest state. Dating back millennia, they describe the entire process of creation and provide a detailed analysis into its composition. The Vedas describe the earth as spherical, giving exact measurements of its radius, circumference, how much the earth bulges at the equator, distances between planets, and the specific orbits of each planet are also given. This is clearly verifiable scientific fact. So why should the Vedic account of the origin of the universe be any less scientific than the accounts given by the modern day scientists?